Hi guys, how are you guys doing? I hope you're having a wonderful day. I'm back with another video. This is my top 5 favorite foundations. Now obviously the base is the most important bit of makeup, because if you don't have the base right, you will look really bad at times. You can either go cakey, or you can either go, obviously you can either not conceal your flaws the best, or it could not be the right shade. So there are so many things that goes into finding the right base for your face, the right foundation for your face. So obviously it depends on from person to person what kind of coverage one likes. For a person like me, like, I prefer a more natural coverage, but obviously when you go out and when you go at a much bigger function or a party, you obviously need a little bit of high coverage to go on a couple of hours. Or there are days when you were just going out for a lunch. So, but you always have that one foundation or those two foundations that you know are your go-to ones and that you keep repurchasing. Now with me, the thing is that I've been trying out so many of them because each one of them has been different. Each one gives a different look. And it's always, obviously when you're a makeup hoarder or when you're fond of makeup, you end up purchasing more than what you require. So, and most important thing is that, you know, it needs to be the right shade, it needs to suit your skin type, it needs to, you know, complement your face, your complexion. It firstly just doesn't need to go, I mean, I being in India, I've seen this, you know, obsession with being fair. Now, obviously, I am a lighter skin tone, and but there are people who are, I mean, I think you're beautiful with whichever skin tone you are, but I see girls who always take a shade lighter, and it just, I feel, looks horrible on them. That's where they go wrong, no matter how good they do their eyes or how good products they use. If your foundation shade is not right, it's just a big, big turn off. So, I personally like foundations which are obviously I'm fond of liquid foundations. And I have a couple of favorites, so I'm just gonna show you what I feel are the top 5 foundations out there. These are really, really good foundations. Of course, I would like to put it out there that these are all in the high-end category, so I probably should just call this all the top 5 high-end foundations. But you know, that's again the thing with foundation, is that it's not something that, you know, has a really small shelf life or something. These are products that go on. Like, these are like, again, these are like investments that you need to, whichever one suits you the best, you should just buy and keep it. Even if it's a little, 1,000, 2,000 more expensive, of course, it's a good product. So, I'm gonna start with the first one. Now, the first foundation of mine, which is one of my most favorite one, is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. Double Wear Stain Wrap Makeup. Now this one, I'm in the shade Rattan, 2W2 Rattan. Now Estee Lauder, I think this is one of the most beautiful foundations I've ever bought. I remember I used to wear MAC all the time, but I was never really content with it. I never felt that I had a perfect, you know, my face looked perfect. So I once went to Sephora and asked the girl to make me try some new foundations, and this is the one she recommended. It had a really good natural finish to it. Of course, it's a high-end, it's a high coverage product, and it stays on. It's a full coverage foundation, but it's amazing on the skin. It's full coverage, yet it doesn't look very cakey, and it blends beautifully with your skin. It's a very, very, very good formula, and it's a must-have. It's a very good formula. It's a must-try. Now the second favorite foundation, number 2 of mine, is the Nars Sheer Glow Foundation. I had seen so many YouTubers, so many bloggers talk about this foundation, and the thing is that you don't get Nars in India, so that was my biggest thing, that how will I know what shade I am. Luckily, once I was traveling to Australia and I went to the Sephora and they had Nars, and I asked them to just show me my shade. She did a lot of swatches and stuff, and she told me that your shade is Stromboli, but the sad part was that Stromboli wasn't available there. They said it's out of stock. So the next time I had a cousin traveling to London, I asked her to bring me Stromboli from there, and I love this foundation. Now, while the Estee Lauder one is a little thicker, this is a little, you know, lighter on the skin, But again, this is also a full coverage foundation, but it's much more natural and it's amazing on the skin. I think this is one of my most favorite foundations I've ever bought. Really, really soft on the skin. And though I also would like to put out there that every foundation has a different finish. Now this one I feel is exactly my skin tone. Sometimes I feel it might be a little darker to me, but the trick is to mix things up and wear them. So I think this is amazing. And while it, I have the older version, they also have one with a pump. It has a good amount of product in it, and both these foundations I've had for the past 1.5-2 years, and of course whatever the mood like, I use whatever I feel like using. So yeah, they both are really, really good. Now the third foundation, which is my favorite, is the Too Faced Born This Way. Now this is the foundation I picked up from Australia when I couldn't find the Nars, and the lady at Sephora, she really recommended that I should give this a try. As the name suggests, Born This Way, it positions itself to be your skin but better. And I think it lives up to it. It's a really, really good formula again, really soft on the skin and really natural. And it's really nice. I'm in the shade Warm Nude, and really good formula. It has a pump, very convenient to use. Now my fourth favorite foundation is not completely luxury or high-end, but I saw a video and someone really, I think Malvika Sitlani was the one who really recommended this foundation, and I thought that I'm a really similar skin tone like hers and I should just give this a try. So it's the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer. I'm in the shade 02 Natural. I ordered this from Nykaa without even swatching or trying it on my skin. I just ordered it because I was really tempted. So I just suddenly become tempted towards something that is really highly recommended. Luckily, it came to be exactly my skin shade. Really, really nice formula. It's really soft. I've never used Milani as a brand before. But I love this foundation. It's again full coverage and it's really nice. Again, it comes with a pump. I have some leaking actually. Comes with a pump, very convenient to use. This is, I think, for $13.25. So this is amongst the top 5 of mine. This is the most inexpensive ones that I have. Last and my absolute favorite, and obviously an investment that I did on myself, is the YSL foundation. It's the YSL Touche Eclat. I don't even know how they pronounce this. So recently went to Dubai and I picked this up because a friend of mine again who's a very similar skin tone. I always felt she had the most flawless makeup. Obviously, I think makeup can be flawless for two reasons. One is you do it well, and second is if your skin is good. If you have a good skin, even your foundations will look really nice and you will have that glow. So of course, I really feel that it's not just makeup that's important. It's important that you eat well, you drink well, and you take care of your skin. You do your good skincare regime as well. But I just went up to her and I said, you have to tell me what foundation you use. And she told me she uses the YSL. And I don't have any makeup for YSL. So anyway, I gave this a try. I think this is one of my most expensive foundations. I'm in the shade BB30. Now this is literally luxury on the face. It is such a thin formula. It's a little watery. I think it's a water-based. It's less creamy. Most of the other foundations are more creamy. This is less creamy, more water-based. But oh my god, it is just literally your skin but better. It just gives you a flawless finish, glowy finish. And it's really, really mild to use. A lot of them are really thick, and for example, I think the thickest and the most creamy one would be the Estee Lauder, followed by probably the Too Faced. I think Nars and YSL are the two foundations that I have that are light yet full coverage and really, really natural on your skin. I think two of my most favorite buys, and I'm really glad I bought these. So these are my top favorite foundations I feel are the best in the market. I do want to try a couple of more, but I think I want to finish these first, and then move to the next ones that I want to try. Also, I would like to put out there, there's one thing that was gifted to me by a friend. What I'm wearing right now, actually, I've never used stick foundations in my life. The only thing besides the liquid foundations that I use is the Studio Fix by MAC. But stick form, I've never used. So, friend gifted me the Makeup Forever Ultra HD stick foundation. So, this was gifted to me recently. Actually, I'm giving it a try. I think I really like it. I've never used Makeup Forever. Actually, I've never used Makeup Forever products, though I was really recommended that the Makeup Forever foundation is really nice, but it never suited my skin. So of course, as they say, even if something's a bestseller, if it doesn't suit your skin, it doesn't suit your skin. So the liquid foundation never suited me, but this I really like. I'm still in the testing phase of this product, but it's very easy. It's a very easy process to just wear it. The moment I literally today did my makeup in like 5 minutes because I thought, okay, the light is right and you know, the baby is sleeping. Let's just quickly shoot the video. So that's why I'm just trying this out. This is also a good product. I'm in the shade. Actually, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3. I don't even know the shade name actually. Again, this was a gift, but really nice. So I hope you like this video. These are my recommendations of the best foundations out there, and I really, really like them. And I've really had a good experience using them and investing in them. So if you want to give them a try, you must. And if your skin tone like mine, definitely give these a try. But I hope you like this video. Please give this a big thumbs up. I'm really excited and always pumped up to shoot more videos to show you guys my recommendations and what I like. So hope you have a really good day. Thank you for watching. Bye.